live from Wichita, Kansas, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the ICT Roller Girls. Tonight we are going to see the number one seed Jet City Bombers taking on the Boulder County Bombers, coming in at they've already had one game today is what I'm trying to say, coming in at an 8th seed. They're from Everett, Washington. They, let's see, Jet City ranked 42 in the Wftda right now. Boulder County from Longmont, Colorado is ranked number 58. Danny Mack, who do we have for a roster for Jet City?
For Jet City, we'll start with number one, Sia Wouldn't Want to Be You. Number two, Simon LeBaum. Number five is Ivana Hercha. Number six, Razor Wrecker. Number 12, Nasty Nikki Nightstick. The Mexorcist, where's number 13? Kat Von Devious is 19. Number 21, Rock and Roll Achola. Number 22, Shock Stopper. Number 39, Wo Nele. Number 44, Sindria. Number 50 is Brute Champagne. Number 80 is The Captain for Jet City. That is Beethoven's Fist. And number 87 is Isla Smashia. The Jet City Roller Girls are 5-1 in the regular season, the 2013 Division II champs.
Okay, Boulder County Bombers again from Longmont, Colorado. They will be wearing the white today. Number 0815, Feisty One, is their captain. Number 11, Trixie Von Tees. 117, Mussolini. 151 is Smashalotopus. Number 2020, X-Ray Vixen. Number 321, Just Dash. Number 408, Brassica Aloracea. Number 451 is Dyna Fire. Number 50, The Original Skankster. Number 504, Fleur de Beast. Number 505, Elise LeCracken. Number 57 is Sauce. Number 717, Hershey Bad. And number 80, Catastrophebe. And Boulder County, of course, coached by Papa Whiskey. Assistant coach is Chet. And the notorious Trail of Trash coaching the Jet City Roller Girls. Boulder County, with a win earlier today, takes them to 3-6 on the 2016 season. They won a punishing physical game against the Chicago Outfit by a score of 162-82.
And on the jammer line for Jet City, they're in blue with white trim. That's number 39, Wo Nele. And for Boulder, they're in white with the red, or the gold trim rather, and that is Feisty 01, the captain.
And we are underway. Taking the back defensive line is Jet City. Boulder up front right now. No jammer making an enormous amount of progress. Here comes Feisty One, though, finding an inside line lead jammer. She has, for Boulder County this year, a 48% lead jammer percentage. And through the pack as well, Wo Nele for Jet City. 4-point hit and quit, Danny, it would appear.
Yeah, Jet City tried to pass, or stash the star, rather. Wo Nele had it and pulled off the helmet cover, continued to go forward, and the first blood drawn by Boulder. That is now 4-0.
Papa Whiskey has to be satisfied with that start. We've already seen this afternoon that a team can play two games and take down a top seed, and that's certainly what Boulder County's trying to do right now. On the jam line, it's Isla Smashia for Jet City. It's Smashalotopus wearing the star for Boulder County. Smashalotopus recycled to the back, as is Isla Smashia, and getting into the defensive end early is Nasty Nikki Nightstick for Jet City. Up at the front of the pack now, we've got Jet City pushing on a determined wall of Boulder City blockers, but no clear advantage right now, Danny.
30 seconds into this one and no jammer has emerged with a lead. It's a tight defense to begin.
Isla Smash, you working a pretty determined three wall up front. Now morphing into a four diamond at the middle of turn number two. Here comes the cavalry now for, the defensive work, or excuse me, offensive work of Nasty Nikki Nightstick actually made room for the Boulder County blocker. Smashalotopus very alertly going in behind Nasty Nikki's Nightstick. Nasty Nikki Nightstick has had to sit down in the 888 penalty box. Early penalties against Jet City are allowing Boulder County to extend an early lead. That's four more for Boulder County. One put up by Jet City.
Yep, 13-1 is the current score. Early on, Smashalotopus, the leading scorer, as the All-Stars, as what we'll call Boulder County, both teams the Bombers. We'll call the Boulder County Bombers the All-Stars just to delineate a little bit, but they have gotten lead jammer in both opportunities.
Ivana Hurtje now, one of the original Jet City Bombers. She is out, and she is the original lead jammer for Jet City in this contest. She's going against Feisty One for Boulder County. Ivana Hurtje bumped to the outside. She's going to have to make a decision now. She will call it off. Nothing for Boulder County. And we're looking, the jam referee is conferring now to see what was picked up by Ivana Hurtje. We'll have more on that in just a second. It was four, Danny.
4 points. Wonelli on the line for Jet City, taking on Smashalotopus, and we're going to see this combination quite a bit. Both of these teams tend to jam with their regulars. This isn't a lot of hocus pocus going on with their rotation, and we haven't seen that yet.
They dance with who brung them. Boulder County on 13 right now, Jet City on 5. Again, we've been seeing a lot of tenacious defense by both teams at the pivot line now. Wonelli makes a break. She is through. She is not lead. Smashalotopus has that designation, but the jammers are face to face, foot to foot. Smashalotopus will call it off. Scoreless jam, Danny.
Powerdyne's changed the game again with newly redesigned Arius Platinum. Arius Platinum, performance redefined. They are part of the Rydell family.
One of the things that Coach Chet told me about this floor is that the skaters are saying it's a blocker's floor, Danny. They're saying it's sticky, and the jammers are having a difficult time pushing off and getting a lot of quick lateral movement. Here comes Isla Smashia for Jet City now. She's going against X-Ray Vixen for Boulder County. Isla Smashia pushing the front of the pack, one to beat. She's nudged to the outside, and quickly regaining her momentum is X-Ray Vixen now at the front of the pack, but the defense is tightening up. Nice bump there by Beethoven's Fist is going to stop X-Ray Vixen in her tracks.
Well, as you mentioned, this is a blocker's delight, and we're seeing that. These grinding packs, they're able to set their walls up and work from there. Both teams are. But it is going to be a grind. This bout is not going to be, so far at least, the tempo is not going to be quick and wide open. It is going to be a grinder.
13-5 in favor of Boulder County. Vixen trying for the front of the pack again. A spin move gets her lead jammer. Only took her 1:04 to do it.
Outstanding footwork by X-Ray Vixen on that one. The wall held firm enough on the inside, and Vixen did the rest.
And through the pack now, Jet City has a jammer in scoring position. X-Ray Vixen going to call it off. And three points are like gold in this one, Danny.
And we're seeing now the jammer rotation turn over, and we're seeing the same jammers go out. These two teams are determined to run the same three out. For Jet City, it's been Isla Smashia, Ivana Hurtje, and Wonelli. And for the for Boulder, it's been Feisty One, Smashalotopus, and X-Ray Vixen.
Pack advantage to Jet City right now. Ivana Hurtje wearing the star, and it's Feisty One for Boulder County. Boulder County still on 16, Jet City on 5. We're 7 minutes gone by. Ivana Hercha, lead jammer again. She's 2 for 2 for Jet City. Still in the pack is Feisty 1. Ivana Hercha on the outside of turn 3, bumped out. Nice defensive stop by Boulder County, but that's going to force Feisty 1 to work on her own against a very difficult defensive setup for Jet City. Through the pack now is Feisty 1. That will be a 4-point hit and quit for Ivana Hercha.
It'll be interesting to see how, what kind of factor fatigue plays if these teams continue to just roll out 3 jammers. Is that going to wear them down? Are they going to be less effective as the bout progresses?
Well, and especially since Boulder County did have that punishing game against the Chicago outfit, but I've been told Smashalotopus is a CrossFit devotee, and she is jamming right now for Boulder County. Assistant coach Chet said she will not run out of gas. She's going against Whoa Nelly for Jet City. Whoa Nelly out in front, finds an inside line and has a half a track on everybody. Whoa Nelly now rolling into the pack in scoring position, setting up for her on the outside with Singria. Singria going to take some offensive steps right now. You can see her going for that seal move on the inside of turn 2, but Brassica Alraceu beat her to the spot. Brassica Alraceu will roll back Whoa Nelly to turn 1. Meanwhile, Jet City defense is just really clamping down on Smashalotopus.
Boulder now 16-9 is their lead. They've led by as many as 12, and that was after the second jam. That was at 13-1. So a nice run getting Jet City back into this, led a lot by that staunch defense.
Smashalotopus finally getting through, but that will prompt the call off. 4 points put up by Jet City, and it's a 3-point game, Danny.
Jammers heading up to the Fast Girl Skates start line. And Fast Girl Skates is proud to sponsor the WFTDA tournament MVPs this year. 9 years dedicated to making you faster. That is Fast Girl Skates.
16-13 in favor of Boulder County. 10 minutes gone by. Sauce jamming for Boulder County, and she's going against Isla Smashia. It's 5-on-5 in the pack, and that's not good news for these jammers. Not a lot of room out there, Danny.
Sauce, a change of pace jammer. Perhaps giving this 3-jammer rotation a bit of a spell. Lead jammer for Jet City as they are now only down by 3 with 19 minutes, 40 seconds remaining in period 1.
Isla Smashia now sees an opening, shut down quickly. Here comes the offense for Jet City. That's the Mexorcist, and she's going to make a little bit of room. Isla Smashia having to work on her own. There we go. That is a 5-point pass. Jet City take the lead with that one, 18-16 now.
Power jam, that's the first lead change in this bout.
Ooh, Isla Smashia making the bodies fly, picking up points 5 at a time, and Jet City rolling on the back of Isla Smashia right now. The power jam is over. Sauce still on an initial pass. Isla Smashia getting smashed into the pack herself as everything's starting to converge in between turns 1 and 2. Oh, a nice move on the outside. Isla Smashia now, she is working on a 14-point jam, and no reason to call it off at this point as Sauce still not completing that very crucial initial pass. This is the big outburst that Jet City wanted.
888 penalty box is clear as these teams have been playing rather cleanly to begin the action. We're 12 minutes into this one.
Yep, and Jet City again, 27, Boulder County 16. Saw still trying to make it through on an initial pass, and Isla Smash is showing her conditioning, going a full 2 minutes, even though she didn't have to. She had lead, but no reason to call it off.
Jet City has taken it and expanded what's now the largest lead of the bout for either team at 14 points, so 30-16. The defense has been solid for Jet, but they continue to grind away with their three hosses as jammers.
Still 5-on-5 in the pack. Ivana Hurtcha now taking on Feisty One. Ivana Hurtcha during the regular season had a 64% lead jam ratio. That's pretty amazing stuff. All of these Jet City jammers very proficient at getting lead against their competition. Here we go, though. It is the playoffs. Ivana Hurtcha doing it again. She is out in front. Jet City making quite a run now. They are up by 14 with 17 minutes left and going to the 888 penalty box. Feisty One, this is green light for Jet City.
Four lead jammers in a row for Jet.
That's what Trail of Trash wanted to see. And a very nice alert skate work on the outside. Ivana Hurtcha putting up five. Now she's just looking for her team to spring her. A little offensive work. Trixie Von T's taking a shot at Ivana Hurtcha, but Ivana Hurtcha, oh, and she is called off for a back block now, and a reversal of fortune, as so often happens, coming out of the 888 penalty box. Here comes now for Boulder County, Feisty One. She does reattach the star. This is a scoring pass. Boulder County needs these points. 22 seconds on the jam clock, so a little bit of opportunity to make up some of the ground for Feisty One. Right now, though, Boulder County allowing Feisty One to work on her own. Here comes the offense, and that will result in a five-point pass. The power jam is over. Ivana Hurtcha looking for more. She's not going to get it. The jam time's out, and boy, 35-21 now in favor of Jet City.
Decent enough penalty kill for Jet City, holding back what seemed like an opportunity for Boulder County to really get their way back into this one. They're only down by 14 as we're reaching about the midway point of period number one.
That's right. Brute Champagne, first jam up for Jet City. She'll be going against Smash-a-Lotopus. It's once again 5-on-5. Brute Champagne looking for the outside straightaway. She's bumped out by Catastrophebe. And at the front of the pack, looking for lead, is Smash-a-Lotopus. She's got it. And Brute Champagne rolled back again by Catastrophebe. This will be what Boulder County wanted. They've got 21 right now. Jet City with 35, but cutting the track is going to be called. Oh, and the Smash-a-Lotopus is going to have to sit down in the AAA penalty box. Power jam Jet City.
Yeah, no argument there from Smash. Probably a little frustration, but textbook track cut. And now it's time for Jet to really put this, start putting a little bit of distance behind them. These kind of opportunities don't come around very often. Boulder tends to be fairly clean as far as their jammers go, as most of these teams are in this WFTDA Division II playoffs here in Wichita.
Well, we saw a flurry of Jet City offensive activity on that last pass, and it paid off. The power jam is over, though, and there's 45 seconds left, so plenty of time for scoring. Smash-a-Lotopus pushing the front of the pack. It is a two-wall braced by the captain, Nasty Nikki Nightstick. Through, though, is Smash-a-Lotopus. She's putting points up. That's a five-point pass. Boulder County now 26, Jet City 35, and you might say that Jet City squandered a little bit of an opportunity on this pass jam, Danny. Jet City defense really holding off Brute Champagne now. And five more. Saw the thumb as Smashalotopus coming around. That's going to do it. The jam time's out. And Boulder County with 31. Brute Champagne getting the points at the end of the jam. 40 for Jet City.
Nice job by Boulder getting back into this one. They're now only down by 9. They've trailed by double digits. The leading scorer after that one becomes Smashalotopus. 19 points so far. Jet City's leading scorer is Isla Smashia. And Wonelli coming to the line for Jet, facing X-Ray Vixen for Boulder.
Boulder holding the back of the defensive line right now. They are paying complete attention to Wonelli, and Brassica, I'll race you, doing a good job of holding the inside line. Meanwhile, not much going for X-Ray Vixen up front. She's pulled by pulled for a track cut by Sin Gria. Nice defense for Jet City. So they get a power jam, they get lead jam. And just like that, Jet City in control again. They're up by 9, 12 minutes left. Boulder County with 31, Jet City with 40, and now Boulder County has to kill this penalty.
And just to be clear, I said Boulder earlier. I mean they're from Longmont, so Boulder not exactly accurate. Boulder County more precise. 40-31, Jets got a 9-point lead.
And nice offense there by Sin Gria, making room. Wonelli spins, puts the cherry on top, gets 5 for Jet City. And the Jet City Bombers, they were the original D2 champions back in 2013. They certainly want to repeat that. They're looking to make a statement right now. The power jam is over. X-Ray Vixen is through. That will be an initial pass that will force the call off, and 3 more for Wonelli. Big jam for Wonelli and Jet City. 48-31 in favor of Jet.
Hey, if you want to talk to us and have very diplomatic tweets that will get right to us, try the hashtag #talk2 WFTDA. There was a tweet. You know, now I've knocked it off my screen, but essentially it said, "Go Bombers." The most diplomatic thing you can possibly say for this Bombers versus Bombers matchup.
I tell you right now, I can see into the future. The Bombers are going to win this. It's just a question of which Bombers. Isla Smashia jamming for Jet City. Feisty one wearing the star for Boulder County and bumped to the outside, having to reset. Feisty one, and again, we're seeing lots of big defensive plays by Nasty Nikki Nightstick at the front right now for Boulder County. Elise LeCracken holding off holding off Jet City long enough to allow Feisty One to get through. Feisty One is lead, but Isla Smashia right on her tail. She's going to the inside. She's knocked by Nasty Nikki Nightstick, and that's a lot of work for a scoreless jam.
Here's where the scrapping for a point here and a point there commences, as these teams have more or less traded points over the last 3 jams. It's been a slight advantage for Jet. They have a 13-10 point advantage. A timeout, in this case, called by Jet City.
Yeah, with 9:51 left. Hey, Trailer Trash, you know, if you win by 10, if you win by 100, it doesn't matter. You move on. And of course, that's what he's looking to do right now. Settle down the troops a little bit. I'm sure he has seen something that he wants the ladies in blue to focus on right now.
Well, it would matter later on as you look toward the next season schedule. The bigger the victory, the bigger margin of victory does seem to help you out there. But right now it is survival mode. These teams are grinding. A 17-point lead by Jet City. Boulder County led early by 12 points, and they've been back and forth a little bit. Jet City took that lead at about the 6th jam and has not let it go since. But I would imagine at this point Jet City's got to continue to do what they're doing, but Boulder has got to switch things up a little bit. We're not seeing it from the jammer line, but we've got to maybe see a little bit of a different strategy to get those scorers free.
Well, and that worked pretty well. It was a 4-3 pack advantage that time for Boulder County, and out in front, Smashalotopus with a very economical stride, still working the defense up front. The original Skankster bracing that wall for Boulder County, and that's a 5-point pass for Smashalotopus. She looks like she's going to try to get a couple more before calling it off on the outside straightaway. She did get three more, and those are three very important points, Danny.
Sangria getting a little love tap at the end, and you got to play to the end of the whistle. Those kind of hits tend to add up. By the end of the bout, if you're battered like that, you can wear another team down that way. On the jammer line for Boulder will be Sauce, and we haven't seen Sauce used all that much. Two jams so far, and she will be taking on Kat Von Devious.
And so both teams going deep into their jammer rotation early. Smart play, the way this game is grinding out, as you say. The jam began with a pack advantage to Boulder County, but standing up in the 888 penalty box is Beethoven's Fist. She's back on the track, but beating the odds. Nice work for Kat Von Devious, lead jammer for Jet City. Rolled to the back now is Sauce, and she's rolled back by Beethoven's Fist. Beethoven's Fist giving her fits in the back straightaway. 5-point pass by Kat Von Devious. That will take Jet City up to 53. Boulder County on 39, and Boulder County now trying to hold off Kat Von Devious. Kat Von Devious smoothly striding around turns 3 and 4, and she puts up a 5 more. Meanwhile, this Jet City defense is just locking down on Sauce.
KVD, it's her first jam for Jet City, and I think you may see her a little more often. Jet City had been very conservative with their jammer rotation, really only sticking to 3 players, but Kat Von Devious making him perhaps rethink that strategy.
Well, it's a number of things. Of course, the pack composition, the Mexorcist, just seems to have Sauce's number there in the back. You can see her along with Sia One Wannabea just continue to roll back Sauce. And boy, big jam when they wanted it from Kat Von Devious. That takes Jet City to 62, Boulder County 39.
Little under 7 minutes remaining. Fast Girl Skates is proud to sponsor the WFTDA tournament. MVP's Fast Girl Skates, 9 years dedicated to making you faster.
9 years is a good thing. 9 years may be about as long as Woe Nelly's been playing for Boulder County. She's wearing the stars. She's going against Feisty One. It's 5-on-5, and Feisty One trying to knife her way through that wall up front. And boy, great urgency by both of these teams getting to the defensive position ahead of the jammers for the most part, but Feisty One getting what she needed. Boulder County needing that lead jam. She's got it. Held in the back is Woe Nelly. She's bumped out and rolled back by the original Skankster now. Scoring pass for Woe Nelly. Nasty Nikki Nightstick gets a dig in, but that will be a 4-point pass. 4-point pass. 5-point pass now as the jam referee wiggles her thumb. Thank goodness for that. And here comes Feisty One looking for a little bit more. Now through the pack is Woe Nelly, and Feisty One taking no chances, calling off the jam, putting up 3 more though. Boulder County fighting back. They're on 47, Jet City with 62.
Well, what's at stake here is an opportunity to advance, and if you don't win your first round game, you simply aren't going to be on that podium. And Jet City, if they, Jet City or Boulder, whoever doesn't win this one will end up in that consolation bracket playing tomorrow night at 6. We got a lot of derby left for that one. We're 5 minutes remaining in period number one. It's 62 for Jet, 47 for Boulder County.
Knifing through the pack, but called for
Out of play.
Out of play block is smash a lot of puss. Lead jammer for Jet City now as Isla smash it. Boulder City, or Boulder County going to have to kill this penalty any way possible. Just Dash holding off, fighting as hard as she can on Isla smash it. But Isla smash it prevailing, picking up five.
Just Dash just plowing in, using the right side of her body, skating backwards, and again going one-on-one. A nice
dishing
nice
out.
Job, but then we saw the Mexorcist turn around and help her jammer, free her up a little bit by engaging that blocker that had been giving her so much trouble.
Power jam is over. Smash a lot of puss back on the track, but this is an initial pass. Holding off the inside is Sangria. Smash a lot of puss bounces outside for profit. Lead jammer and calling off the jam quickly after that. That'll be Isla smash it, but big jam for her. She picks up 10.
One of Jet City's primary MOs on defense so far has been swallow up that jammer, use four blockers if you can, and then if you can also at the same time, let your jammer fend for herself on the outside. It's worked sometimes. That last jam it did not, because that four pack was not able to contain the Boulder County jammer.
Jet City up by 25, 72, 247, 3 minutes and change left in this first period. Ivana Hercha out in front, lead jammer, X-Ray Vixen not far behind, five on five in the pack, and the pack is speeding up, trying to get up to the front. Oh, and bumped to the inside on an attempted apex jump. Picking up a one for her effort is Ivana Hercha, and that shows how much she wants to win this game, Danny, sacrificing the body for one important point.
Gritty, gritty play, and clean play as well from Jet. Six penalties so far. Man, that's an incredibly low number. For as smash mouth as this bout has been.
Triple A penalty.
For Boulder County as well.
Triple A penalty box is empty right now. We've got Brute Champagne wearing the star again for Jet City against Feisty One for Boulder County. Boulder County, Feisty One pushing the front of the pack. Boulder County, as they've done so far in this game, holding down the back. Now going on offense, Jet City's going to spring Brute Champagne. She is through lead jammer. 73 for Jet City, 47 for Boulder County, 155 left, and Feisty One looking to pass the star now. She's got Elise LeCracken in her sights, but in the meantime, lapping the field, Brute Champagne puts up five. Jet City making a run.
That's Brute's second jam, and has already put a total of 10 points on the board.
Boy, nice to have that in your back pocket if you trail a trash. Cutting the track now is going to be the call on Feisty One. And it is Christmas in August for Jet City right now with a minute 15 seconds left. Out in front, Brute Champagne. She's got five. She's looking for more. Holding her off, though, at the front of turn one. Is Boulder County doing the best they can with a short staff? Five more, though, for Jet City.
And we're nearing a very critical point. This will presumably be the final jam of period number one. Jet City has slowly been building up their largest lead, which is where they stand right now, 83-47. And a lot of that has to do with just a total stoppage of defense. Over the last five jams, Jet City has only allowed 8 points.
They are clamping down. Woe Nelly wearing the star in a power start for the ladies in blue. And Jet City, Woe Nelly, lead jammer, standing in the 888 penalty box right now is Feisty One. She has been released, but this will be an initial pass. She is bumped to the inside and recycled. Meanwhile, scoring points for the Bombers of Jet City is Woe Nelly, completing the initial pass. Very important task for Feisty one now. That'll force the call off by Wonelli. Wonelli going to take four more points into halftime. And Jet City now ahead by 40 points. Their biggest lead, 87 to 47. We are at halftime. Danny, amazing action so far.
Yeah, and so much has been controlled by penalties in this one. Jet City, 50 points off jammer penalties. Think about that, 50 points. Our current score, as you see, 87 to 47. So that completely turned the tide of this bout. They'd be trailing by 10 without those points off jammer penalties.
Well, and Jet City, of course, having the luxury of the number one seed, got to watch all of the action so far today. They saw the hard-fought game that brought Boulder County to this game against the Chicago outfit, so they're taking advantage right now. We'll see what Boulder County has in the tank when we come back after halftime. Division II playoffs here in Wichita, Kansas. Game number five is halfway in the books. Jet City Bombers on top right now by 40 points. Danny Mack, how did they get there?
Well, not what you'd expect out of the typical 1-8 matchup, that's for sure. And a lot of this came down to penalties. And in this case, seven of the first half penalties, get that, seven for BC, five of them were from jammer no-nos. So you don't see that very often, your jammers out penalizing your blockers. Jet City, one jammer penalty.
Well, that's going to help your cause.
It
no
sure
doubt
will.
About that.
It sure will. The final five jams, by the way, Jet outscored Boulder County 39-8. So, really, that was a nice tightening down of a lot of things for Jet City to stave that off and start the and finish the second half very strongly. And as we kind of look back a little bit, we talked about those jammer penalties for BC, but the Jet City jammers really doing what they do.
Yeah, Jet City have unbelievable numbers season-wide. Wonelli has a 78% lead ratio. Ivana Hertia has a 64% lead ratio. Isla Smashia has a 56% lead ratio. Nice trio to stick out there if you're Trail of Trash. And very even scoring. Wonelli with 338 points on the year. Ivana Hertia with 345. Isla Smashy with 346. And that's coming into today's game, of course. They're only going to be adding to those totals. Again, it is Jet City from Everett, Washington, the number one seed, the Bombers, taking on Boulder County, the number eight seed from Longmont, Colorado, the Bombers, and we are underway. Pack advantage for Boulder County as we get started. Isla Smashia jamming against Feisty One. Feisty One pushing a two wall at the front of the pack. And it is the Mexorcist holding as long as she could. Lead jam Boulder County.
And Boulder County starting off with a statement, and they had to do that. You've got to get back in and take command at some point, and they are. Boulder County just kind of exerting it right out of the gate. Let's see how sustainable this is, because as we said, Jet City really tearing it up toward the end of the second period. We'll kind of monitor what adjustments they've made, but yeah, out of the gate, it's been considerably quicker, the pack action, to begin the second period.
Star was passed to nasty Nikki Nightstick, who deposited the Boulder County jammer on her back, and that forced the call off.
Fans, the S1 Lifer helmet is the best fitting and safest helmet for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer. S1 makes the best helmets and pads for roller derby. S1, part of my uniform.
4-3 pack advantage right now for Boulder County. They've got 52. Jet City has 87. Out in front, but called for cutting the track. Smashalotopus is going to have to go to the triple eight penalty box. Ivana Hertia now rolled back by Just Dash. The Boulder County defense cannot allow any more power jam points in this period, Danny.
Third penalty for Smash-a-lot-a-puss, and those jammers have just been, frankly, brutal in this. Those penalties have been putting their team in a very difficult position.
Ivana Hercha negotiating the pack untouched this time. Puts up five more for Jet City. Takes them to 92. Still a 40-point lead. Boulder County on 42. On 52, but now five more for Ivana Hercha. The power jam is over. Smash-a-lot-a-puss completes the initial pass very quickly.
Point distribution very two-sided for Boulder County. 22 points for Feisty 1, 27 points for Smash-a-lot-a-puss.
Four more on the back end for Jet City. Jet City now over 100. 101, Boulder County 52, just 27 minutes left in this game. Two blockers in the triple eight penalty box for Boulder County.
Fans, Adam Skates just got a lot more colorful. Adam Skates, hashtag color me Adam. Color Falcon plates and color Q4 boots. Check out all the wonderful new goods from Adam Skates.
And here comes that substitute jammer everybody likes to have, Kat Von Devious for Jet City out in front as lead jammer, stuck in the pack. Feisty 1 not having much luck against the Jet City defense. Look at the speed generated by Kat Von Devious. That's a 5-point pass.
Kat working to the outside and then turned on the Jets to get around what looked like at least one or two blockers around her, but she just outsped the defense. Cut to the inside this time.
Does it again. Five more. Nasty Nikki Nightstick was captaining the defense. She gets back to the front again, takes a parting shot at Feisty 1. Feisty 1 through on an initial right now, but Kat Von Devious races to the outside, picks up four more, a 14-point jam for Kat Von Devious.
Kat Von Devious, 28 points total in two jams. She is tied, a three-way tie now for leading point scorer out of Jet City. 28 points for three different players, Isla Smasha, Ivana Hercha, and KVD.
Okay, Jet City 115, Boulder County 52, 25 minutes left. We've got Woe Nelly jamming against Smash-a-lot-a-puss. Still a blocker down. Boulder County is going to have to try to hold Woe Nelly. They can't do it. She's lead jammer. Smash-a-lot-a-puss getting through on her own, stopping the bleeding right now. Here comes Woe Nelly on the outside. Bumped hard by Elise LeCrack, and that'll force the call off. And getting up slowly after that hit, picking up 4 points, however, is Ivana Hercha for Jet City.
The hashtag
Woe Nelly, excuse me.
Yeah, the hashtag talk number two, WFTDA, is how you can talk to Gretchen and me. And Leslie, no pun intended, asking, are the Bombers using a three-jam rotation? Well, both teams are named Bombers, and neither, they've kind of both abandoned that three-jam rotation strategy somewhat. Boulder County still more or less sticking to three with Sauce mixed in there slightly, but Jet City's now getting some work out of Kat Von Devious.
X-Ray Vixen acrobatically getting lead jammer, still caught in the back. Isla smash you right now. Brassica, I'll race you with the rollback. Putting it, hard to the floor. And Nasty Nikki Nightstick is going to take a low block penalty to the triple eight penalty box, but that probably was worth it in many respects. Probably enjoyed it and stopped the scoring momentum for X-Ray Vixen also. X-Ray Vixen now with five. Isla Smasha being rolled back again. This time it's by Dinah Fire. Rollbacks galore. Sia wouldn't want to be a. Going to roll back X-Ray Vixen now. X-Ray with 5 points. looking for more. She's going to get tangled up with See You Wouldn't Want to Be It. That's an out-of-play block. Going to send See You Wouldn't Want to Be It to the 888 penalty box. Through the pack now, picking up a star pass is Nasty Nikki Nightstick. The pack is igniting in speed.
Yeah, this has been very different, a very different pace in this second period. Things are getting a little more spread out and more open skating going on as you are watching.
X-Ray Vixen now putting up numbers. That's 5 points. She's got lead jammer, but she must like what she sees. She's going to continue to push it. Now on the rollback is Catastrophebe. That's going to do it for the jam. Five more, and nice little move put on by Boulder County. Now they've got 72, Jet City with 121.
That's huge. The blockers freeing up X-Ray Vixen on that one. She's now the second leading scorer for the All-Stars. And they need that. They've got to get some different scores, have some other options that can give you looks other than Smash a Lot of Puss and Feisty One, who have put up the lion's share of numbers, but their point scoring differential is low. Minus 11 for Smash, minus 19 for Feist.
Pack advantage for Boulder County at the start of that jam. Feisty One just barely holding on to the inside line. She picks up lead jammer. Ivana Hurtja in hot pursuit. 3-on-3 in the pack right now. And Jet City speeding up. Here comes Fleur de Beast trying to make some room for their jammer. What is it going to be? Ooh. 3 points picked up on the back end. That's a win for Jet City.
It is, and especially to try to stop that momentum that Boulder County had started to get. They're trying to slow this game back down, it looks like, as Boulder County had some success spreading them and shredding them, as it were, really opening up the offense a little bit, allowing those jammers some space. And I'm going to keep an eye on the spacing because it looks like Jet City might have had something when they were keeping this sucker tight.
21 minutes left. Jet City has doubled up on Boulder County. It's a power jam now as Kat Von Devious in control. Smash a Lot of Puss sent to the 888 penalty box. Penalty killing now imperative for Boulder County. And Kat Von Devious is sent off on cutting the track. That was smart play by Brasilica. I'll race you on the inside straight, drawing that cutting penalty. That will spring Smash a Lot of Puss again. Jet City doubling up on Boulder County, 124-72.
Smash a Lot of Puss returns from her fourth penalty, and this penalty served by Jet City will be just about a full 30 seconds.
Smash a Lot of Puss completes the initial pass with help from Brassica Alracia. Now it's 4-on-4 in the pack, and Kat Von Devious is standing up. No jammer with lead designation right now, so 45 seconds left. Plenty of time for scoring.
About 20 minutes left in the bout. Jet City up 124 to Boulder County's 72.
And defense now solidifying for both teams. It's basically 4-on-1. Getting through at the front, though. That's Smash a Lot of Puss. That's a 5-point pass. Five very well-deserved points, well-needed points for Boulder County. Now we got a pile up in turn two, and that's working to Smash a Lot of Puss advantage. Smash a Lot of Puss getting up on the toe stops, just running down that sideline.
Well, Boulder anchoring down, and with that pack in their part of the pack in the rear of it, anchoring down and forcing those Jet City blockers to spread apart, try to brace themselves, or continue to chain themselves together as to not allow the jammer to go through, and that leaves a lot of spacing. Again, that word is very critical at this point. Where there's space, these jammers are moving very, very well.
Yeah, as we had heard, the consensus is this is a blocker's floor. So when it's 5-on-5, it's going to be a little difficult. Now we've got Sauce jamming for Boulder County. She's going against Wonelli. It is a 4-3 pack advantage for Jet City, but a nice defensive stand put up by Elise Kraken, rolling back Wonelli almost to the fast girl start line. Wonelli gets ahead of steam, though, and comes through on the inside. Lead jammer, Jet City. Still fighting hard now. Sauce is not finding the going easy, and Wonelli on the outside, untouched. Sauce now working against the front of the pack. She will be rolled back by Rock and Roll Achola. And boy, all of a sudden, Jet City asserting themselves, making the statement that they probably wanted to make coming into this as the number one seed.
No question. And Sauce really struggling, continues to struggle. That wall just engulfing her.
Yeah.
And now she's trying to push forward. And it's just not a lot of going. She'll get shoved out of bounds, and they are doing such a good job, they meaning Jet, of recycling, waterfalling, whatever you want to call it, those blockers forward, continuing to move them in a position to make a play.
Singria and Beethoven's Fist were very instrumental in that last defensive stand. We've got a timeout on the track being called by Boulder County. Boulder County has 83, Jet City with 138, 17 minutes and 15 seconds left.
Fans, Rydell Skates is the innovative leader in the roller skating industry for over 70 years. Make your skates your own with custom colored, handcrafted Color Lab boots by Rydell Skates. And if you are listening to us on WFTDA.TV, that's free. But if you want to watch the action, you have a lot of options, and they are affordable. For just $12.99 for the entire weekend, you can get the high-quality video feed, and that works for all, each weekend you can buy individually, or you can buy them together, and the entire tournament, the entire slate of tournaments, rather, $75 will get you every bit of that. So that's seven WFTDA playoffs and the championship, 75 smackers. That's a darn good deal on WFTDA.TV. Now, if you're heading to Champs, VIP tickets are available for $125. We'll tell you more about that in a moment.
Yeah, coming out of the timeout, it's 5-on-5 in the pack, and Feisty One doing what she needed to do for Boulder County. She is lead jam. Meanwhile, the defense clawing hard on Isla Smashia. Isla Smashia not complete on her initial pass yet. She's taken down very strenuously. No call on the play. Fighting at the front, a 5-point pass now for Feisty One. Boulder County not going away.
Not going away at all, and now trailing by 50, which is attainable. We've got half the bout and more to go. Boulder County's just got to continue to string it together. I mean, this isn't kind of a get a little bit back. They have got to try to get that momentum squarely back in their favor. They had it briefly in the first period.
Brasilica Alracia and the original Skankster working on Isla Smashia. They did let her go to complete the initial pass now. And Feisty One sees what's going on. She's going to call it off. She's got four more. That's a big jam for Boulder County. 14 points takes them up to 97. Jet City's got 138.
And fans, S1 Lifer Helmet is the best fitting and safest helmet for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer. S1 makes the best helmets and pads for derby. S1 is part of my uniform.
15 minutes, 40 seconds left. Ivana Hurtcha jamming for Jet City. She's going against Smash a lot of puss for Boulder County. Nice defense by Beethoven's Fist. Dashes Smashalotopus's dreams on the outside. Meanwhile, Ivana Hurtcha on a scoring pass. She's lead jammer.
And that's a critical lead jammer if they want to get that momentum back themselves. 138-97, the current score, with Jet in command for much of the bout, about 15 minutes to go.
Mussolini lays down Ivana Hercha, but Ivana Hercha, fighting on her own, picks up five more. Mashalotopoulos still caught on the initial pass after that bump out by Beethoven's fist. And boy, and no points are easy in this game so far. It's, as we said a couple of times already, it is a blocker's track. You can see that, Danny, in this defensive work.
Yep, it's been just slow, but not deliberately slow. They just are playing slow. They're going after each other, and these jammers are having a hell of a time getting around some of these tight walls. As you're watching, as I speak, there's a lot of that. And oftentimes, when they're able to spring their jammer, Boulder County has done it by perhaps using one player to kind of go in and muck up what has been a tight wall, and that's what you just saw there.
Five more points for Ivana Hercha. Mashalotopoulos finally getting through, but Hercha wanting a little more. She's bumped to the inside by Elise LeCracken. That will force the call off, but that's a 13-point jam for Jet City. Jet 151, Boulder County 97.
Elise LeCracken had a big jam as a blocker in that one, getting her jammer free enough to where that jam had to be called off. It was critical because Jet City continued to pour it on. This is their largest lead, 151-97.
Boulder County needing something right now. They send X-Ray Vixen to the line. Kat Von Devious, the wunderkind from Everett, Washington, who saw her coming, but she's got lead jammer again. Oh, and cutting the track will be called on X-Ray Vixen, and this just made Kat Von Devious's stock rise even more, Danny.
X-Ray Vixen now two penalties. And X-Ray Vixen, when she's been jammer, that she's the only player in positive territory on the plus minus.
Well, Kat Von Devious rolled back now, but Nasty Nikki Nightstick leading the offensive charge for Jet City. Catastrophe takes a shot. The original Skankster is going to be sent off. And Kat Von Devious working very deliberately now as the power jam expires.
I like Kat Von Devious's patience. She's got the speed clearly, but we're watching it now. Worked over by a couple of players, getting dragged back, but you don't see her get shaken too easily. She just follows it. And just like that, draws the track cut, or commits the track cut. So she'll head away for 30 seconds. But yeah, she got dragged back and lost that patience that I was just talking about.
35 seconds left on the jam clock, and X-Ray Vixen can make some noise here. She's looking at the front, the Mexorcist and Nasty Nikki Nightstick. Boy, they're teaming up on the outside of turn four.
X-Ray Vixen's got to do it quickly, too. 16 seconds remaining in the jam, and she is stuck behind three Jet City blockers.
Well, she's got a couple of points, but getting out of that pack is going to be a challenge. There she does it. She's got five. 1 second left. The jam timer expires just as Kat Von Devious was released from the 888 penalty box.
Kat Von Devious went in there with 4 points, so the score is now 155-102. Jet City, a 53-point lead with 11 minutes to go. When you need to roll quick, think quick. That's KWIK, Quick Bearings, part of the Rydell family, where precision meets performance. Roll faster, farther, and smoother with precision bearings from Quick.
4-2 pack advantage for Jet City. They're sending Wonelli to jam against Feisty One. And nice work on the inside by Elise LeCracken. Once again, at least holding off Wonelli for a little bit until the Boulder County blockers can get back out there. Wonelli lead jammer for Jet City. Jet City doing what they need to do right now.
They are, and they've got to continue to work that clock. I think at this point, longer jams may benefit them. The longer they can stay out there and force that time to work away, the better.
Elise LeCracken received the star. She's called for cutting the track, however. Another power jam for Jet City as LeCracken sent to the triple eight penalty box.
Elise LeCracken now two penalties. And just a difficult situation made more difficult by jammer penalties.
Whoa, Nelly pushing the front of the pack. Nice work again by Dinah Fire on the inside straightaway. That will end the jam right now. Still in the triple eight penalty box, although standing up, is Elise LeCracken.
And LeCracken had received the star and will be coming out momentarily, but she'll be taking on Ivana Hercha, who has 44 points, leading all scorers in this one. Looking at the other high scores, 38 points for Smash Elatopus. That's the leading scorer for Boulder County. Power Ali all come free, and the penalty box, the triple eight penalty box, is free.
And Elise LeCracken sprung from the penalty box, gets lead jammer Boulder County, just refusing to say die in this one, and they've got time. It's 8 minutes and 39 seconds. They're down by 58. Lead jammer Elise LeCracken, Ivana Hurchis still caught on her initial pass, holding the outside line is the original skankster. Meanwhile, the Jet City defense teeing off on Elise LeCracken. Beethoven Fist just laying her down. Smash Elatopus receiving the star pass now. She'll obtain a couple of points, 3 points on that pass. Ivana Hurchis still not completed her initial pass.
I'll tell you, one player doing some work is Brassica, as she just got sent packing to the inside, but I want to say she's harnessing the power of the onesie to make that happen.
She's been doing it all game long. Five more now for Smash Elatopus. A no lead jammer. 35 seconds left on the jam clock. Ivana Hurcha engages at the back of the pack. Four more for Smash Elatopus at the front. Brassica, I'll race you, going to be called off now. 4 for 4 as the jammers continue to lap the field. Nice work by Smash Elatopus, finding some room. Look at her dig down. She's got 10 seconds. She says, maybe I can get a couple more. And here she comes. She's going to do it, Danny.
On one skate on the outside.
That will end the jam. Smash Elatopus showing that fitness on that jam. No doubt about it. Jet City now 168. Boulder County 122. And we have a timeout called by Boulder County.
Good timeout. You know, you've got them to use at this point. And that's their second timeout that they will use in this bout. 168 to 122, but regroup a little bit. Find out what's working well. It seems to be when Boulder County can get the pace going a little quicker, they've shown a little bit more success. So what can they do to get that? Well, they've tried a few different tactics. They've spread the pack apart. They've used their blockers to maybe one blocker go in there and break up what traditionally had been a strength, and that's Jet City's four wall, braced or otherwise. So if they can break that up and get some spacing, get those jammers a little bit of floor room, that seems to be working for them. But the problem is doing that. And Jet City, every time Boulder County seems to come back, seems to get a little bit of that going for them, slams the door.
Well, and Boulder County's got their work cut out for them. Two blockers in the triple eight penalty box. So it's a 4-2 pack advantage up now for It's Brute Champagne jamming again for Jet City at the Fast Girl start line. She will be going against X-Ray Vixen. And Brute Champagne taken down by Mussolini. Every second that Mussolini can hold off Brute Champagne is a win for Boulder County, but Brute Champagne achieves lead jam.
X-Ray Vixen, it seems like she's had to work her way through about 10 players on the floor because Jet just continues to work those blockers up, but X-Ray Vixen equal to the task. She plowed through and made that call off happen. Had she not worked her way through those last three blockers, this would have been a higher score than three.
Brute Champagne putting up three. And again, Trail of Trash got to be happy to be able to send somebody to that Fast Girls start line without a lot of jams on the season, but who holds it together. All right, 171 now for Jet City, 122 for Boulder County. 5-on-5 on the track. We have a rollback by Trixie Von Tees.
Time is of the essence here. They're under 6 minutes, so you're talking about maximum 5-6 jams potentially. Boulder County has got to make their move. This is a great start. This is the way you do it. Get lead jammer and then see what happens from there.
And whoa, Nelly having difficulty as she's rolled back again by the original Skankster. Here comes Feisty One. That'll be a 5-point pass. Whoa, Nelly has taken off the helmet cover. She is continually rolled back again by the original Skankster. Ooh, devastating blow sent up there by Singria. That will take that'll take Feisty One back to between turns one and two.
Feisty One's been very efficient, been out there 14 times, leading all jammers in that category. 50% lead jammer percentage, 41 total points.
Well, at this point, you have to wonder, as you said, Dan, with the time being the issue that it is, if you're not getting points at this point and you are lead, maybe you want to think about calling it off. But right now, Feisty One has 5 points, and she's working on a second scoring pass. Whoa, Nelly has not completed the initial yet. Five more for Boulder County.
Yeah, I think Boulder's just going with what works at this point. They know that they've got a jammer out there that's got a bit of a hot hand, and Feisty One continues to show them that this perhaps is the right decision. Nice clear out block.
Trixie Von Tees getting it done for the Bombers from Longmont, Colorado. Boulder County clawing their way back. They're at 137. Jet City at 171. 3 minutes, 56 seconds left. One more scoring pass and five more on the board. A 20-point outburst by the Boulder County Bombers.
Huge. Absolutely huge, and they've got to do it again here. We're at 3 minutes and 38 seconds remaining. A lot of that's going to tick away as the skaters get back on the floor. But that was huge. Smash a lot of puss coming up to the line for Boulder County. She will be taking on Kat Von Devious.
And Smash a lot of puss taking off. Did she get it? She did. She's lead jammer for Boulder County. Boulder County just has the hot hand right now, as you said, Danny.
Gretchen, very important. Two clock stoppages available for Boulder County. They can use them when they want to, and again, stacking up points right now. Time is waning. They've got under 3 minutes to try to use both.
Well, Kat Von Devious is still mired in the pack, though. Smash a lot of puss going for all she can. Von Devious through now. So, Smashalotopus having a decision to make. The Mexorcist tries to bump her to the outside. Smashalotopus going to call off the jam. Nine more for Boulder County. Takes them to 151. 20-point game, Dan.
There is a timeout. This one actually called by Jet City. A little surprised by that one. They're the ones that need to move the clock. Down by 20 points, but perhaps this is a reset. Maybe they've got to get some things straight. But you saw that momentum get right back toward Boulder County. That very much helps them. Now they have three play stoppages to try to get that, get back in this one.
Sure, that's several opportunities, at least two, if the gameplay works, if they have control of the gameplay. Of course, that's the key to a situation like this. Time, score, control of gameplay. Well, time is easy. It's 2 minutes, 32 seconds. Score, that's easy. 171 Jet City, 151 Boulder County. Boulder County making a furious comeback over these last couple of jams, Danny.
Our guy Dylan Powell from the Apex has provided us some pretty decent stats, and this one might surprise you a little bit that there actually has been a one seed that's fallen. Boulder County trying to do that again. 16% of the time in Division II playoffs, the one seed has lost their opening bout against an eight seed.
Okay, even strength, 3-on-3 in the pack. Ivana Hurtcha jamming for Jet City. X-ray Vixen for Boulder County.
And Boulder County down by 20 points. Jet City, critical lead jam. 171-151, 2 minutes 11 seconds. And you see the sign from the Jet City bench to keep on rolling and keep on milking the clock.
X-ray Vixen bumped to the inside. Jet City want this one. They want it badly. They wanted to make a statement. Now they're just going to have to survive. But Ivana Hurtcha on a scoring pass. Cutting the track is the call. That goes on Beethoven's fist. Still 1 minute 39 seconds. As Ivana Hurtcha on a scoring pass, she's going to have to call this one off. She does. And now we will see a play stoppage, no doubt, by Boulder County.
Well, and Jet City had about a minute left that they could have worked off if they so chose. Elected not to, elected to tap the hips and stop the play there. A timeout now by Boulder County.
24 points. 24 points in a minute and 26 seconds. How do you do that, Danny?
Well, step one, lead jam. Step two, no penalty. Beyond that, I wonder how they're going to attack this, because as we've said, when Boulder County has rolled well, they've done it by spacing. They've done it by giving themselves more open floor, but you know, Jet City, on the other hand, isn't allowing that. And particularly in the second period, they are wearing down a little bit, so it's a little more likely. But,
well, now in the 888 penalty box, we have two Jet City blockers. So that certainly helps you with step one.
Yeah, and another key to this is that one timeout that they still have. The challenge that Boulder County can make, it's not a timeout. They can use it as a timeout.
Or
they can challenge whatever they want. A minute and 25 on the clock, and as soon as this one begins, step one, get lead jammer.
Feisty one going against Wonelli. Feisty one, does she have the urgency to push through that two wall? She's facing off against Razor Wrecker. She gets
through. Huge play by Feisty one. Huge play by the Boulder County blockers. Had a slight pack advantage and used it to their fullest.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick takes a shot at Feisty one, but it only propels her forward. Feisty one with five, and it's a 19-point game. The clock is winding down. Wonelli completes her initial pass. Feisty one gonna have to hit and quit. She goes to the inside. She will do just that. She's gonna call off the jam. She gets four more, and now it's 160 Boulder County, 175 Jet City.
And here's the thing. Do they use it? Do they use the official review? And we're watching time just tick down, and we're not seeing Boulder call that official review. They've got a stoppage in their pocket.
It's the time is clicking down. 17, 15 seconds, and it's a 15-point game. Ivana Hurtcha, we are going to play roller derby. Ivana Hurtcha jamming against Smash-a-Lotopus. They are putting a lot on Smash-a-Lotopus's plate. She gets through. She is lead. Oh, no, she's not. She is not lead. an improper pass of some sort, and now we have a down skater.
No pass, no point. The bout clock has expired.
The scoreboard saying an unofficial final. Jet City surviving 175 to 160. Danny, this one came down almost a flip of the coin for Boulder County.
Now, here's the official review call by Boulder County. What I'm wondering, and our producer Andy Marone also pointed this out, I'm wondering if Jet got lead jammed before that was stopped. Now, we heard the stoppage, we heard the whistles go, we've seen, it's a matter of was that lead jammer acquired by Jet City? If it was, that poses a very interesting quandary here. Now, the official review, they could really call whatever they want at this point, but they've got to be good. They've got to win it, for one, if they want to get back into this one.
Oh, sure.
Boulder County would like to challenge the lack of a lead call.
There you go.
They're
challenging the lack of a lead call right now, and an opportunity to be in the discussion right there among the officials.
And this is nice, but I don't think that's going to get them another jam. I mean, I think regardless of the outcome, this is Jet City's very close victory.
Well, Jet City, as we said at the beginning, the Bombers were going to win. It was just a question of which ones. And, boy, you got to give a lot of credit to Boulder County fighting back at the end of this second period. But as we had discussed, there were clock stoppages available.
Jet City was awarded lead first. No call stands. Reviewed, not retained.
So the
game is final.
The review is not retained, and the game is final, Danny. Jet City surviving by a score of 175 to 160. They will move on.
Andrew Marone's got a little more color on that play.
Yeah, Boulder County did challenge the fact that they did not get lead. There was a no pass, no penalty on Boulder County. Jet City then obtained lead designation, called the jam off at the final jam. Review was unsuccessful. That's the game.
Okay, Jet City moving on now. Boulder County will be taking on
Yeah, Boulder County advances. They'll get the winner of the game that's after this, Brandywine versus Kansas City, that 4-5 matchup. That one, they'll play tomorrow at 2.
Well, Jet City will get them.
Yes.
Jet City as the winner today will get the winner of Brandywine versus Kansas City. That one's going to be interesting, too. It's a 4-seed versus a 5-seed, and I'm looking, Boulder County is going to get the winner of Carolina versus whoever gets beat in the next game.
Yep.
Make sense?
Boulder County stands to play either Brandywine or Kansas City.
If you don't have a bracket at home, what are you doing watching WFTDA.TV?
As does
bracket.
Jet City.
Fix it off yourself.
Yep, as does Jet City. So the outcome of next game determines who will play who from this one. But, man, Jet City got it together at the very end. A little bit of a sloppy finish, but a lot of that was procedural. And clock management becomes a question. I mean, who am I? I'm not a skater. I'm not a coach or anything like that. But when you have an official timeout like that, to me at least, you would think it would behoove you to spend that official timeout while you have time on the clock, while you know you can use it. Instead, Boulder County decided to keep it in their pocket. They ended up using it at the end, but it was for a play that, a challenge that turned out to be inconsequential for the outcome. They couldn't have gotten they weren't able to parlay that challenge into more time, into another jam. So Boulder
split
County. Split-second decisions. I mean, we're talking, you've got 30 seconds to make that call. So do you make it or not? And there are other thought processes that go on. I mean, do you go with getting your skaters out there and ready? Do you go put your best jammer out as they did and go for it? And in that case, it just didn't pay off.
Well, Boulder County losing a heartbreaker here, not for lack of effort, continually pushing against Jet City. Jet City would get up by 50 points, and they would come back. And I'm sure Jet City, Trailer Trash, was saying, what do we have to do to put these people away? Well, finally, they had to let the clock run out. And a couple more minutes, who knows, could have been a different story. But moving on in the winner's bracket will be Jet City. They will take on the winner of Brandywine versus Kansas City at 2 o'clock tomorrow. Don't forget to catch that one. It's going to be a winner.
It will be. And tonight, the next bout coming up, Brandywine versus KCRW. A big time for these two teams to shine. And we saw some weakness in Jet City a little bit toward the end. They're still the number one seed, but it's got to give some hope to those teams that whoever can come away victorious in this next one at least has a shot to beat a very strong number one seed. And on the converse, that kind of maybe yanks Jet City's chain a little bit. Tells them, look, we're a little bit infallible here, and maybe gives them a little more focus for that next game. But we'll see. Brandywine, very strong. Kansas City, very strong. A couple of teams that really could put on a good show. So we thought maybe there would be another upset. Not the case. Only one upset so far in Division II here in Wichita.
Boulder County losing a heartbreaker. Jet City taking it by 15 points.